That sounds bloody awesome.
So, in case this doesn't get tagged onto the other video, or however this works, we are at Analog Man. Mike's here helping us out, and we thought the question that we're all asking all the time is, what fuzz should I get? And this is a particular journey that I'm on at the moment, having I recently got I think it's a 183 Sun Face. So we've got Analog Man's creation of classic Fuzz Face circuit, but in some of its most common variants.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we've got germanium, these two germaniums,
mm-hmm.
these two silicons. Now, the kind of, Mike, am I right in saying that the kind of standard germanium fuzz that you do is this one?
Yes.
Okay, and the kind of standard silicon?
Right.
So, Jimmy's silicon fuzz was 108?
Probably.
Something like that. And the 183 is in that camp. So rather than go into the whole, you can read so much about this on Mike's site, on the Analog Man's site, about all the different transistors that are used to create the fuzz. But we thought we'd just have a listen and a little A-B comparison.
Mm.
You're already gone. Dan's already gone. So come on. Let's start with germanium, because most people know that germanium is, you know, when the original Red Fuzz Face came out, it was germanium,
mm-hmm.
Two germanium transistors, right? And so let's start with the standard issue.
Okay.
We don't want to say anything is standard from Analog Man, but as standard as it gets, right? We've got them on these switches here, 11, 12, 13, and 14, running into this really cool Fender. What is that, Pro Junior?
Pro Junior.
Pro Junior, so 10 watts? Something like that. And a 67 Super Reverb, mm-hmm. and they're both running together.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a glorious noise. So amazing. Here's the sound of the 2 amps.
Running into the Marshall cabinet.
Oh yeah, okay, yeah. So so it's not coming through that speaker. As all good guitar players should do, it's running through a 4x12. Dan, let's hear the amps. He's
just
happy.
Just
68, 69, did we say?
Yes.
Yep. Mike's 68, 69 telly, and this is a 78, 79 Strat, of course. Very cool, it is too.
This has Mike's pickups in.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I didn't know.
The big T Telecaster pickups, yes.
No way.
Lindy Fralin, Jim Weeder pickups.
Okay.
Very nice.
Dan, I want you to start bridge pickup, and okay. We're going to do the thing that Dan hates doing. You're gonna play a power chord,
okay.
Something, and I just want to switch between the full fuzz sound. Yep. So as you can see, we've got them set up arbitrarily. Mike set them up this way, so I'm assuming that you like them set that way, Mike.
Yeah, although this bias is up pretty high, but you can try adjusting that by ear.
Sure. So this to, so the face should be facing us.
Yeah, face at 12 o'clock.
Okay.
Standard.
Okay. All right. We're gonna start here, and we're gonna work. No, actually, let's start with germanium. Let's A-B the two germaniums.
Okay.
Yep.
Thank you.
we have two comedy occurrences going on. One is this camera is sliding, so we're just going to stop and take that.
Okay.
And the other is I had to step on Dan's foot while he was tapping his foot there because it was making the camera shake.
Okay.
As you can tell, we are slightly shambolic because we've got on a plane and come across the Atlantic with the most minimum gear we can carry. So, you know, and we're in the middle of Mike's office, which is, there's noise from traffic, we've got lights on, we've got, in fact, it's a lot darker than it was. Have we drawn the curtains?
No. Oh, have we?
No.
Hopefully, by the time you hear the guitar audio, it'll sound great because it's just the mics on the...
Sounds amazing here.
On the amps. Okay. Do the same thing. Can you roll the volume back a little bit?
Yep. It's literally go back a tiny bit and...
Yeah. So I hope that serves as a kind of, so many people we talk to, and whenever we do a video on fuzz, usually someone says, oh, I just can't get with fuzz, can't understand it, it all sounds fuzzy and horrible, and I lose all the dynamics of my guitar. I don't think it gets much more dynamic than that, does it?
No, because it's all about, you know, using just a tiny little adjustment on the volume, and it just gives you so many different shades of gain, but you hear that it brightens up as well. It's changing the you know, just that resistance to the input of what it does to that circuit, and it's just magical.
Tell you what else is really interesting. So we're using G2 here. Typically, a traditional fuzz face really needs to see the guitar, right, Mike?
Yes.
Because it needs the relationship between the
inductance of the coils and all that sort of stuff is absolutely crucial.
We can talk to Mike about that in a second when he's a bit closer to the vocal mic, but G2 feels like it's preserving that quite nicely.
Right, absolutely.
We haven't got any buffering.
The reason we're doing it, the reason we're using G2, because we're isolating each one.
Yeah.
So we're not even chaining those up together. Each one's in their own loop. So when we go through it, what you're hearing is that, and it's like perfect environment.
And the G2 buffers are off right now.
Off.
Yeah.
Okay, that's why it's working so well. It's perfect for that.
So, okay, so you've heard Germanium with the telly. Why don't we try silicon with the Strat for a second?
Okay.
And do the same thing, if you wouldn't mind.
Yep.
So we're now dealing with 11 and 13, which is BC-109, BC-183, silicon.
Okay, we'll start with the 109.
I'll just go full out, bridge pickup.
Thank you.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
Really fascinating from where... So, in case you didn't get that, most of that was with the... you heard. When it's fuzzy and thick and fat, the volume knobs all the way up. But actually, some of my favourite sounds there were with that setting and just knocked off a little bit.
Mm.
Check this out. So, here's full on, right? Because it goes from being like a full-on, you know,
compressed and you know, wall of noise
to being mega dynamic,
yeah,
like a really great distortion pedal.
Can you set the pedal up to do that with the volume on full?
Certainly,
you can.
I can adjust that while you're playing and show you.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's do that.
Which one would you like that?
This one.
183.
Yeah.
We only have two screws in here to make the process a little faster.
Okay, so Mike has joined us, and so this is the trim pot for...
This is the bias, and the white is what we call our clean trim pot, which is an input pad.
Yeah.
And by turning that down, it's basically like turning your guitar down, but it doesn't seem to reduce the fuzz quite as much. But it just cleans it up nicely, and you'll see.
So better than I can explain. I'll be on full volume.
Crank that up all the way, and we'll set it here.
Okay.
And maybe you can even... Well, I'll adjust it, I guess. You can do it with your fingers or a screwdriver.
Okay.
Right now, it's set for full fuzz.
I'm going to make sure that we can see with this camera. And then, yes, it is wobbling, I know. But, you know, that's how we roll.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Substantial slow cleanup on the volume pot. It won't be as more noticeable on the germanium ones, and the silicon ones it's a little bit subtle.
If it's not coming through on the audio, it's something that I can really feel.
I can hear it clear as day. It just adds a clarity to it. It still has that fuzz,
right?
But it just adds that clarity to it.
Yeah. It takes away a little bit of the flabbiness.
And that's super interesting because, you know, here we are going through. So the Pro Junior is overdriving a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
The Super Reverb will be overdriving a little bit, but not a lot. You know,
very little. Yeah.
If you say to most people, "I'm going to plug a Fuzz Face into a Super Reverb," and just if any Super Reverb fans out there, what you'll be asking is the bright switch turned on. I would imagine not.
No.
No. And the treble's down at It's four. Kind of four or five.
Let's try this one. That one cleans up really good.
Okay. So we've just gone through it with the Strat silicon and affecting the internal trimmer. We're now going to do it with the Tele Germanium. This is the red dot
Germanium. Right, and right. We have the fuzz up pretty high, volumes up pretty high, biases around medium.
Okay. So I'll do this with the bridge pickup?
Sure.
Because I was on the neck, so yeah, why not?
Okay.
Just...
control on the guitar will be more easy to dial in now with that turned down.
Let's can you
just give me a second.
That felt good too, sitting in front of the speaker cabinet. That felt good.
It's unbelievable. It's extraordinary.
Come on, turn the volume down. Go on the neck pickup, turn the volume down and let's see what happens.
Okay.
I'm trying to, Dan's having a moment, so let's keep him in the moment, shall we? Okay, so, what's the trimmer actually doing?
It's adding resistance at the input.
Mm.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's exactly what you do when you're rolling off your guitar. That's what you're doing. You're adding resistance here. The difference with having it at this end is that you don't have the capacitance. When you use this here, you have got the capacitance of the cable, and that adding the resistance with the pickup in conjunction with the capacitance has a different effect than just having it after the capacitance of the cable. I love that. That
Me
is
too.
Amazing.
I've really learned something. I've learned that for my purely personal tastes, I like it with the increased resistance.
Yeah.
Mm. It kind of cleans it up a bit. And, you know, for anyone out there, you wouldn't do this in every situation, but, you know, people are going crazy for adding buffers, so they keep high end and keep kind of... you know, that kind of glassy high and everything.
Mm-hmm.
That does that does it just in a way that is so amazingly musical. And Dan, I'm also slightly, I don't want to say annoyed, but I'm, it's that kind of, oh yeah, everyone says the NKT275 transistors
right
sound great. To me, that's probably my favorite of these on the board. I like this a lot.
Right.
But, and again, it's going to change with amps, with guitars, it's going to change with how you dial them in, it's going to change with, and sorry, I'm now rambling because I'm having a moment as well. This adjusts the bias on the?
Yes.
Yeah.
Turn it up, you'll get a little brighter, a little harder sound. You just turn it down, it gets looser and a little flabbier.
So you can just get it in the place you want it.
So one of the questions that we get asked about fuzzes, there are guys who struggle.
Yeah.
Right. And it's understanding that the fuzz is not just a distortion pedal. It's not just a thing that's going to make you add noise and stuff to the signal. It's like an instrument in itself. There's so much going on with it, you know, and it's understanding the relationship between what's happening here and this. It's incredible. It's just incredible. I mean, I've got fuzzers and stuff. I don't have anything that sounds like this.
No. Well, okay, right. We could go on. We could compare every transistor under the sun. I think I'm not sure what results that would yield, other than
this. Sorry, these two are germanium.
Correct.
These two are silicon.
Yep.
Okay. I just want to do one quick test.
Okay.
Right. One thing that happens with fuzzes is obviously the guitars are going straight to the input. But one thing that happens is when you put an effect after them and you buffer the signal coming out the pedal.
Okay, do you also get the high end back?
Yes, you do. So, for example, but what I want to try is the difference between the germanium ones and the silicon ones.
Interesting.
Right? So, this is an analog delay, absolutely gorgeous. We have it on the show a lot. It sounds amazing. But have a listen to what happens with the germanium unit when I add the delay onto the end. So just, so if you put your guitar on for a sec.
Where am I?
You're there. One. Right, so now just play for a sec. So you notice when I, with your normal direct sound, when I add the delay, your direct signal is untouched, right?
There was no tonal change at all, apart from the delay.
Exactly, just the delay. Now, watch what happens when I add the delay after the delay.
Shall I have my volume knob all the way up?
You have it wherever you like.
We'll do both.
Okay.
Let's start all the way up because, you know, that's the right thing.
Now, if I do, let me try the 275.
Okay. Let's turn this back down this way so it's a bit fuzzier.
Okay, now we'll try it with the silicon. Thank you.
fascinating. Sorry, apologies for the endlessly repeating phrase. I was urging Dan to switch there.
So,
oh my God,
it's really interesting. So, one thing that you can do is have an always on buffer after it.
Yeah.
Right. And I was actually really surprised that the
this one seemed to have
it was less effect. So I'm assuming the output impedance of this one's a bit lower.
Should be similar.
Right.
Yeah.
Interesting. Very interesting.
So that it does explain something. That rehearsal recently, I was running my clon after my fuzz.
There you go.
So and the buffer's always on.
Yep.
Ha! Mm. How funny.
I first noticed it when I had a fuzz face made for me in Australia, and I got my first memory man. I was really excited. I had my fuzz going, got my memory man, I turned it on, and it went really shrill. I'm, no, the memory man's broken.
Yeah.
I took it back to the shop. Exchanged it, got the other back, plugged it in, exactly the same thing.
But I actually really like that. I very much like what it's doing.
Yeah, and that's the thing. If you like what that buffer's doing, then all you need is a buffer that's on after the pedal. Just as long as it's not on before.
Q8000 comments, can you do another show on buffers, please? I think we'd better.
Yeah, but it's...
One thing, to interrupt, you can edit this out, but it seemed like the buffer in that other one changed it a whole lot more.
Yeah, the so if we have a listen to the phaser.
So this is a different kind of... it's a Walrus Monument harmonic trem, which has a different buffer in it, I guess.
So have a play of this one.
Yeah. Playing a load of conkers there because it's just makes you want to play.
Yeah. So the this one though, because it's a harmonic tremolo and you are going between treble and bass, so it is going to, you know, it is changing the tone. But it's an interesting thing.
I noticed it more in the monument.
Yes, but because of the harmonic tremolo.
Yeah.
You're pulsating between bass and treble. Bass
okay.
And treble, so it is going to treble onto the output anyway.
Yeah.
If we just turn it to standard tremolo, just try that for 1 second. Let me have a go at that. Just for 1 second. So, okay, what blows my mind? They're just the harmonics. You hear so many overtones and things in, you know, so you can just grab one when it sounds that good, and you just grab one note, and so much is happening. It's so good, so good. I think for me,
you liking that one?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I must admit, when I'm every time this one comes on now, I'm going, yeah. They could be set differently inside and all the rest of it, but...
I want to do just one quick thing.
Okay, and we are going to have to, because as you will have noticed by the look of the video, the sunlight has gone away, so we're probably colours all over the place by this point. It has been a bit of a...
emotional journey.
Emotional journey. So, you know, we can just add that to the...
I just want to try... So, right, the issue that I've always had with fuzzers is Telecaster, bridge pickup, bringing the rock. Sorry, let me just sort this out because this is...
Is it hurting your brain?
It is.
Fair enough,
mate. There we go. Now we're happy.
I thought I was the OCD one.
So just quickly, you know, I'm all...
He never does anything.
...emotionally spent after, you know, playing with these. But the issue that I've always had with a Telecaster is bridge pickup, because, you know, I'm giving it the love that it needs to bring forth the rock. And the issue that I've always had with fuzz pedals is when I do that, they tend to cave in a bit.
Okay. You know? Yeah, so I can relate to that.
I just want to quickly go through these with that sound. Now, I'm assuming if I use that trim pot and just add a bit more resistance on that, it's going to add...
Well, here you go.
It's going to reduce some of the little bit of low-end tubbiness and add a little clarity.
Here you go. That's this one. That's
problem solved.
Yeah.
Problem solved.
That's phenomenal. That is phenomenally interesting.
I'm back to this one now.
And Mike, do they all have that?
Yes.
So all of the Sun Faces have that.
Yes, they do. It has the same... Some of our other pedals, like the Sunbender 1.5, has got that too, which has got a nice cleanup.
Okay, one little addendum to the... I alluded to the fact that the NKT275 transistors were the ones that everyone goes, ooh, about.
Those are pretty much out.
Okay. So, borderline impossible to get these, and they command ridiculous prices on eBay.
Yes.
So, the question is, does the NKT Red Dot sound similar to the 275? So, we are going to check that at this very juncture. And while I'm plugging that in, Mike, I noticed that we've got power jacks, often a problem with a lot of fuzzes, but it's center negative 9-volt.
It is, but you cannot daisy chain. You can't share power. But,
yeah.
If you use one of your isolators, it's fine.
It's fine.
But
yeah,
just
yeah.
Don't share that power with any other pedal because the power is reverse and it will blow up your power supply.
Okay, so there you go. You heard it from Mike. I'm pretty sure it says that in large letters on the product page.
And we've got the clean trim pot on that NKT all the way down again,
I believe, just so that they're fair.
So that's where it would be.
Yes.
As factory standard.
Exactly.
Factory. It's about as much like a factory as, as my sitting room. Okay, right. I'm bringing the rock this time.
Okay, here we go. This is the 275.
Thank you.
I think I prefer
Don't
this
tell
one.
Anyone, I prefer that one.
Yeah.
That one might have a little higher gain, which or a little lower gain, which might be nice.
Which, you know, is not a convenient conclusion, but I think there was, whether it's to do with where the bias pots are, where the trim pot is, that...
Let's say...
A little more clarity
I've
in
got
that
to,
one.
I've got to hear it with a telly. Okay, I'm really sorry.
Don't sorry. Apologize, Dan. Lower gains sounded a little bit clearer, and to me it had a slight more quackiness in the EQ, like a more vocal thing going on. But I thought
this one for, at higher gain, that one had a punchier mid range, but
a little clarity, more clarity.
Yeah,
yeah. But no, I'm digging that.
You going with that one? I guess they all vary ever so slightly.
Yes.
So that's
the
nature
of the transistors that are in them might be a little different.
Amazing.
We could go on all day. We could go on all day and probably will.
It's fascinating.
I've certainly learned something.
Man,
I've learned the descriptions. If you go onto the Analog Man website and read the descriptions, they are full, they are descriptive, they kind of tell you what you need to know, but my ears have connected the dots. Now I fully understand those words.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Wow. Amazing. Amazing. This is, you know, when you have the conversation with Mike and he says every little thing matters and this is the result.
Yeah.
And it's extraordinary. And it's just that sound, it just inspires you to play. You know, both of us. There are times we just sort of, it just comes out, you know? Amazing. Anyway.
Cool. Okay.
Guys, thank you so much for watching. Really hope you enjoyed that. Massive thank you to Mike and the boys here. It's been an amazing day. Big thank you to our guys on Patreon. Thank you guys so much. Also, massive thank you to our preferred retailers in the UK and Europe is...
Anderson's Music of Guildford.
In the USA...
Riff City Guitar, where we are going tomorrow.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
And in Australia...
Pedal Empire in Brisbane, Queensland.
Well, I'm heading to in December. It's going to be great fun.
You can still buy camo t-shirts and ordinary t-shirts. And what else should we start selling? I think we should do the brassiere.
Oh, yes!
Anyway, please head to thatpedalshowstore.com and see if you can pick yourself up some bit of merch.
Brilliant. Cheers, guys. Thanks so much. And we'll see you next week.
Bye-bye.
Bye.